So hello my dear aspirants and guys, welcome to this video where we are going to discuss the most important current affairs that are relevant for your examination of RBI, SEBI and NABARD guys. And if you guys are preparing for any other banking examination or any examination guys where current affairs plays an important role, the lecture can be helpful for those examination also. So today I will be discussing with you the current affairs that is from 1st to 2nd of December here. And here guys, we will be discussing about the two important cabinet approvals that has recently been given, which prevails the justice initiative or which shows that how much government is concerned regarding the legal justice as well as the social justice for the community here. So let's quickly start with the topic here guys. The topics that I'm going to discuss today, that is first of all, the topics which are relevant for phase 1 and phase 2. Then I'm going to discuss those topics which are relevant only for phase 1. We will be discussing the topics, practicing the MCQs. And at the end, guys, I will be discussing with you the homework question that I have shared with you in my previous lecture. So let's talk about the topics for the day, guys. The topics are, sabse pehle kya diya? Humne janam diya hai. PVTGs ke liye. PM Janam Scheme. Second are the fast track special court schemes, again a legal justice scheme that is being seen in news. We'll be discussing about that. Then with respect to the phase one topics, three prominent personalities are seen in news. These are Mrs. V.R. Lalit Ambika, Arshia Sattar and Henry Kissinger. Along with that, we will also be discussing about the World AIDS Day that has recently been observed on 1st of December here. So let's quickly start with our topics that are relevant for phase 1 and phase 2. Sabse pehle baat karte hain janam. Janam diya sarkar ne kisko? To the particularly vulnerable tribal groups. This topic has already been discussed with you by Devanshu sir in his lecture of 16th of November. But till that time guys, the approval was not there, just a basic launch was there. तो अब देखिए सबसे पहले जन्म का मतलब क्या है. जन्म का मतलब है दैट इज जनजातीय आदिवासी न्याय महाअभियान. दैट इज अ काइंड ऑफ जस्टिस यू आर प्रोवाइडिंग टू द पीवीटीजीस. एंड व्हेन आई टॉक अबाउट पर्टिकुलरली वल्नरेबल ट्राइबल ग्रुप्स गाइस, दिस ईयर इन द आरबी एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ 2023 वी हैव विटनेस्ड दिस क्वेश्चंस ऑन PVTGs also, particularly vulnerable tribal groups pe sawal aaya hai. So these are very important for the examination. Now, when I talk about these things guys, first of all, before I come to this topic, why PVTGs are important? Because in India, these are the special groups, 75 PVTGs are there in India, jo ki 18 states mein hai in the country, and from there, the questions were being asked in the examination. Now, what the government are providing you, the government kaise justice de raha hai? Government is now focusing on providing the basic amenities to the tribal groups here. For that, the government has earmarked under this scheme, that is 24,000 crore rupees approximately has been earmarked here, after which approximately 15,000 crore rupees will be earmarked by the central government and remaining money will be given by the state government here, which will be approximately 9,000 crore rupees. Agar exact figure ki baat karo, toh it comes to 8,768 crores for state and 15,336 crores for center, which tells us it is a central sponsored scheme. Second question guys, it's not a single ministerial initiative. It's a multi-ministerial initiative where 9 ministries are being involved, which will be initially focusing on 11 critical interventions. 11 basic cheeze provide ki jayengi pehle scheme ke under. Ab wo 11 basic cheeze hain, let's discuss about that. But isse pehle story to hum banate hain is scheme ke bare mein. Ab socho PVTGs ko kya kya requirement hogi, unke paas kya cheeze nahi hain. Think about them. They do not have the basic amenities like kya hai, sabse pehle ghar. रोटी कपड़ा मकान बोलते हो तो पक्का हाउस हैज टू बी प्रोवाइडेड, व्हिच विल बी एप्रोक्सीमेटली 4.9 लाख पक्का हाउसेस विल बी प्रोवाइडेड हियर. फिर घर तक जाने के लिए सड़क भी तो चाहिए, सो द रोड्स विल बी कनेक्टेड हियर व्हिच विल बी एप्रोक्सीमेटली 8000 किलोमीटर. नाउ यू हैव अ रोड, यू हैव अ हाउस, व्हाट अबाउट द वाटर हियर? यू नीड अ पाइप्ड वाटर ऑल्सो. दैट इज द पाइप्ड वाटर सप्लाई विल बी प्रोवाइडेड टू ऑल द पर्टिकुलरली वल्नरेबल ट्राइबल ग्रुप हैबिटेशंस हियर. देन for that, the community water supply will be created, which will be approximately 2500 village habitations with a population of less than 20 households will be given a proper community water supply. Ab iske baad kya hai? Aapke paas pani hai, ghar hai, sadak hai, व्हाट अबाउट योर हेल्थ नाउ? हेल्थ के लिए द मोबाइल मेडिकल यूनिट्स विल बी सेट अप हियर व्हिच विल बी अप्रूव व्हिच विल बी वर्किंग अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ आयुष. जहां पे मेडिसिन कॉस्ट क्या लिखा गया है, मेडिसिन कॉस्ट विल बी अप्रोक्सीमेटली 1000, दैट इज 10 पर डिस्ट्रिक्ट हियर. देन होस्टल्स विल बी क्रिएटेड हियर एंड देन कम्स टू द एजुकेशन पार्ट, दैट इज वोकेशनल एजुकेशन एंड स्किलिंग विल आल्सो बी प्रोवाइडेड अंडर द 60 एस्पिरेशनल ब्लॉक्स ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलरली वल्नरेबल ट्राइबल ग्रुप्स. बेसिक्स यू कैन सी ना, बेसिक बेसिक कनेक्टिविटी जो है वो यहां पे प्रोवाइड की गई है. अलॉन्ग विद दैट द नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग वाज कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ आंगनवाड़ी सेंटर्स. सो गाइज, इन माय प्रीवियस लेक्चर आई हैव डिस्कस अबाउट आंगनवाड़ी सेंटर्स, दैट इज आंगनवाड़ी प्रोटोकॉल फॉर दिव्यांग, वी हैव डिस्कस इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर. आई होप यू हैव वॉच्ड दैट वीडियो. नॉट वॉच द वीडियो, आई विल से वॉच दैट वीडियो बिकॉज दैट प्रोटोकॉल इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट विच नीड्स टू बी रिमेंबर्ड फ्रॉम द पर्सपेक्टिव एग्जामिनेशन. फिर मल्टीपर्पज सेंटर्स बनेंगे. एनर्जाइजेशन ऑफ हाउसहोल्ड, दैट इज लास्ट माइल कनेक्टिविटी विल बी प्रोवाइडेड टू दिस हाउसहोल्ड्स हियर. Then solar energy. So 0.3 kilowatt of solar energy grids will be set up here. The point is where we are targeting, the provision has to be provided for 1 lakh households. Then ab aapne solar grid banaya hai to usse kya hoga, solar lightning will be given in the streets and the municipalities here, and along with that Vandhan Vikas Kendras will be set up here. So 500 Vandhan Vikas Kendras are going to be set up here because hum log hamesha baat karte hain tribals kahan pe rahenge, forest, and for these important kya hain, unko main line cinema mein leke aana, yani ki main line peoples ke paas leke aana, kaise Vandhan Vikas Kendras will be working on that thing, that is thing here. Then is installation of mobile towers, because mobile ka zamana hai yaar, to mobile towers will be constructed so that connectivity can be made by them. That is the basic essential things are being provided under this specific scheme here. Okay, so this is about this specific scheme, but what about other ministries? जैसे मैंने आपको अभी बोला था, ministry of ayush जो है वो किस पे work करेगा, that is on wellness centers. So wellness centers will be provided here, which means mobile medical units who are being operated by the ayush facilities will be overtaken by ministry of ayush here. फिर हमने पढ़ा vocational education, skilling, skill is skill development, so there the ministry of skill development will be helping here by providing the skills and vocational training to the particularly vulnerable tribal groups. तो आप देख सकते हो पूरा का पूरा भारत एकदम इकट्ठा आया है किसके लिए, for helping the particularly vulnerable tribal groups. So I hope guys this scheme is clear to you. Now let's end this scheme with a very basic important fact that needs to be remembered. So in previous lecture I have discussed about the census data that was regarding the disabled people in India. It was approximately 2.2% of the population which is disabled as per the census of 2011, which says at current population 3 crore ke around disabled population in India mein. But when I talk about ST population, so it says India has an ST population of 10.45 crore people, that is as per the census 2011. Now out of that, that I've already discussed with you, we have 75 PBTGs which are being located in 18 states and UTs along with UT of Andaman and Nicobar here. Okay, so this was the thing that needs to be remembered from the perspective of the examination. So before proceeding to the next topic guys, let's make a quick summary for this thing, quick revision. It's a scheme that is Pradhan Mantri Jan Jatiya scheme has been launched for the particularly vulnerable tribal groups. Second point, it's a multi-ministerial initiative where 9 ministries will be focusing on 11 critical interventions. 11 critical interventions kya hai, humne abhi discuss kiya hai. Sabse pehle pakka house dena hai, piped water supply deni hai, then we will be providing them vocational education, we will be providing them community water reserves. Along with that, we will be helping them in setting up medical units, mobile towers. That are the basic things will be provided here. Along with that, if I talk about the other ministries, Ministry of Ayush will be working on setting up of the mobile medical units so that medicines or health facility could be better there. And for training purpose, Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship will be coming forward there. Next point to be remembered here is total money given is 24,000 crore rupees. Approximately 15,000 crore rupees are being earmarked by the central government, and the remaining money, approximately around 9,000 crore rupees, is being earmarked by the state government. देखो 9000 नहीं है पूरा, उससे कम है, but approximately बोल रहा हूं, तो ये चीज का ध्यान रखना यहां पे. और फिर हमने डिस्कस किया इसको एंड में दैट 10.45 करोड़ पीपल इन इंडिया आर कवरिंग एसटी पॉपुलेशन ऑफ इंडिया एंड देयर वी हैव 75 पर्टिकुलरली वल्नरेबल ट्राइबल ग्रुप्स विच आर रिजाइडिंग इन 18 स्टेट्स एंड द यूटीज ऑफ अंडमान एंड निकोबार आइलैंड एज वेल एज इन लक्षद्वीप आइलैंड. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट दिस टॉपिक. नाउ गाइस लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द सेकंड जस्टिस सिस्टम ऑफ इंडिया, दैट इज द स्कीम दैट इज द फास्ट ट्रैक स्पेशल कोर्ट स्कीम. पर उससे पहले मैंने आपको बताया था कि देवांशु सर ने आपको सारी स्कीम पहले भी डिस्कस की हुई है. दियो द बेसिक वर डिस्कस, अब जितना भी अपडेट आया है दैट आई एम डिस्कसिंग विद यू इन दिस लेक्चर हियर. नाउ फास्ट ट्रैक स्पेशल कोर्ट स्कीम, यू माइट हैव नोन दिस स्कीम बाय द नेम ऑफ 1023 फास्ट ट्रैक स्पेशल कोर्ट स्कीम ऑफ द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ लॉ. सो इट इज द सेम स्कीम बट द लेटेस्ट अपडेट इज दैट नाउ द स्कीम हैज बीन एक्सटेंडेड for the next 3 years, which means now the tenure of the scheme has been extended till 31st of March 2026 year. So it's a scheme that was launched in 2019. अब देखो इसकी जरूरत क्यों पड़ी. In India, guys, we have seen that there are multiple cases which are there in the courts of India. इसी में से एक केसेस किसके रिगार्डिंग आते हैं, the POXO cases. That is the prevention of child of sexual offences cases. Then the rape cases for the minors. तो वो cases को कैसे handle किया जाए? Rape cases को कैसे handle किया जाए? For that, the government come up with an initiative. That is in 2019, Department of Law and Justice under Ministry of Law, they have come with a scheme by the name of the Fast Track Special Court Scheme. Under this, there will be some fast tracks. स्पेशल कोर्ट्स दैट वुड बी सेट अप हियर. सबसे पहली बात, यहां पे कोई भी नया कोर्ट नहीं बन रहा है, कोई भी यहां पे नई फैसिलिटी नहीं है, ऐसा नहीं कि नई रिक्रूटमेंट नहीं. जुडिशियल ऑफिसर्स 7 मेंबर्स विल बी अपॉइंटेड हियर अलोंग विद देम. दस द अरेंजमेंट्स विल बी मेड बाय द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट इन कंसल्टेशन विद द हाई कोर्ट्स हियर. तो दे सेड ओके वी विल बी कमिंग हियर एंड वी विल बी रिजॉल्विंग द केसेस इन अ वेरी फास्ट मैनर. तभी नाम आया. When the scheme was launched in 2019, the scheme was launched for the purpose of 1 year. उसके बाद फिर extend की गई, because you can see the number of pendency here. Looking at the pendency now also, the government said, let us enhance the scheme for 3 years. That is the point to be remembered here. It's a central sponsored scheme, guys. The other prominent to be remembered here is, जैसे मैं आपको बताया, prime focus किस पे है? That is effective implementation of Criminal Law Amendment Act of 2018. Targeting will be on the rape cases and the POXO cases here. Now, when the scheme has been enhanced, at this point of time, a financial allocation of around 1952 crore has been marked. That is at this point of time, jab 3 saal enhanced kiya hai. Toh kitna diya gaya? Center around 1200 and remaining will be given by the state government here. So clear about this thing. अब देखो यहां पे सबसे important point, because center is also contributing, state is also contributing, but from the central perspective, the funding will be done on the basis of Nirbhaya fund scheme. तो हमने पढ़ा हुआ है Nirbhaya fund जो है वो किसके अंदर आता है, Ministry of Women and Child Development के अंदर. It's a non-lapsable fund. That is the point is it's a non-lapsable fund. So from that perspective, the center share will be given under this specific scheme here. As I've told you, koi bhi structure yahan pe naya nahi banega. Aur dusra kya hai? The responsibilities of state government who will be consulting the high court judge. So center government sirf aur sirf isko monitor kar raha hai, jabki sara ka sara state government karegi. Now, when I talk about this scheme, guys, I told you that 1023 fast track special courts has to be set up here. But here, one very important point that was marked by the Supreme Court of India was, it says, wherever there are a cases, that is, it mandates the establishment of exclusive POXO courts, that is, which will be focusing specifically on the Prevention of Child Sexual Offences Act, jo cases hain. Agar wahan pe cases aapke 100 cases se zyada hain, to wahan pe mandatory hai, you have to set up a fast track court here. Initially, when the scheme was launched, there were around 389 fast track special courts, which were for the POXO cases, and the remaining one were for the rape cases as well as for the POXO cases. Now, if I talk about the latest data, guys, here, so yahan pe kya number of fast track courts which are exclusively for the POXO Act has been enhanced to 411, and there we have 758. तो approximately 1100-1200 के around, 1100 के around, 1100 के around आपके fast track special courts are working in India, which are operationalizing around 188,000 pending cases have been resolved here. You can see guys, 188,000 cases resolved, अभी भी pendency India में बहुत है. तो इसलिए scheme को enhance किया गया कि हमें ये सारे cases priority पर resolve करने हैं, because this is one thing we have seen here. केसेस लटकते रहते हैं और होता क्या अल्टीमेटली, द पीपल हु आर सफरिंग आर द फैमिली मेंबर्स और द विक्टिम्स हियर. सो दे आर, दे शुड गेट अ फास्टर ट्रीटमेंट. फॉर दैट पर्पस दिस स्कीम हैज बीन अनवील्ड बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया. सो दिस वाज अबाउट दिस स्कीम गाइस. अगेन इफ आई क्विकली रिवाइज दिस स्कीम विद यू, इट्स अ स्कीम ऑफ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ लॉ वर्किंग डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जस्टिस. देन पॉइंट क्या है, एंश्योरिंग द प्रॉपर इंप्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ क्रिमिनल एक्ट ऑफ, that is Criminal Amendment Act of 2018 as well as the POXO cases. Primary focus will be on rape and the POXO cases. So if there is any district jahan pe 100 se zyada POXO cases hain, to wahan pe it's mandatory to set up a fast track special court. The fast track special courts, there is no special infrastructure that will be created here. Other thing is, state government is the sole responsible for setting up the fast track special court, and they will be consulting the High Court of इंडिया है. एंड गाइज अगेन आई एम सेइंग यार, ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट चीज है, बिकॉज आप देख रहे हो कि क्वेश्चंस ऐसे, जैसे मैंने टॉक अबाउट द इंडियन पॉलिटिकल सिस्टम, नाबार्ड इज आस्किंग क्वेश्चंस, इवन आरबीआई इज फोकसिंग ऑन दोस थिंग. हम इसको सोचेंगे पॉलिटिकल सिस्टम का क्वेश्चन है, बट दे कैन रिलेटेड विद जेंडर इश्यूज एंड दे कैन आस्क यू क्वेश्चन ऑन दैट थिंग. तो ये सारी चीजें हमें पता होनी चाहिए, दैट्स इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द एग्जामिनेशन. और दोनों फैक्ट्स, व्हेन द स्कीम लॉन्च्ड it was having 1023 fast track special courts, but now the number has surpassed more than 1100 here. So this was about the scheme guys. Now let's quickly talk about the topics which are relevant only for the phase 1 of the examination. So kaun se hai, sabse pehle look at the picture behind me, that is V.R. Lalitambika. She is a very renowned ISRO scientist and has now been conferred with the highest civilian award of France, that is Legion d'Or honor. If I talk about her achievement here guys, she has been awarded for her significant contribution for fostering the space relations between India and France here. And if I talk about the award, so award ne diya tha, award diya tha hamare ambassador to France ke liye. Ab agar main Legion d'Or honor ki baat karu, to humne bahut naam padhe hain jinko recently awards mile hain, but this award is very very important because generally the questions are being asked here. And Chandrasekharan ko bhi mila hua hai, Ratan Tata ji ko bhi mila hua hai, kafi prominent personalities of India ko mila hai, even the Prime Minister of India has recently received this award. Now let's discuss little bit about this award here guys. So this is an award which is the highest civilian award of France. It was started by Napoleon Bonaparte in 1802, that was at the time of French Republic. तभी से दिया जाता है फॉर द एमिनेंट पर्सनैलिटीज, इट कुड बी फ्रॉम फ्रांस और इट कुड बी आउटसाइड द फ्रांस ऑल्सो, हु इज वर्किंग ऑन मेकिंग अ गुड टाइज विद द फ्रेंच गवर्नमेंट हियर. सो दैट इज द प्राइम थिंग टू बी रिमेंबर्ड हियर. ठीक है जी, 1802 में ये बना था नेपोलियन बोनापार्टे. अगर आप कोई भी सर्विसेज दे रहे हो टू द फ्रेंच गवर्नमेंट, दिस विल बी गिवन. इट कुड बी इन आर्ट, इट कुड बी इन साइंस, इट कुड बी इन पॉलिटिकल अफेयर्स ऑल्सो. Along with that, when this award was given, इनके साथ एक award और दिया गया, that is again being presented by the French government, that is the Chevalier d'Ordre des Arts, that is the Order of the Arts and Letters Awards that was being presented again by the Ambassador of French to the prominent Indian person, that is Arisha Sattar. So if we talk about Arisha Sattar, इनका एक NGO जिनका नाम है संगम, तो उसके लिए इनको ये award दिया गया था, and she was very happy to share that award with her team of Sangam, which was in 2008 started by her, and the next person is David William Gibson here. Now the prominent thing to be remembered here is guys, along with that, she has also received the Sahitya Academy Award. So Sahitya Academy Award bhi inko mila tha for her books, because she is a very renowned author and her main personification is जो बच्चों के लिए, she has made the adaptations of Ramayan, Mahabharata, Bhagavad Gita and other written important books she has written for the children here. So one of her book, that is Mahabharata for the children, was awarded the Sahitya Academy Book Award, that is for the children's literature in the year 2022. So that's again a fact that needs to be remembered from the perspective of the examination. तो दो नाम पढ़े हमने फ्रांस से, V.R. Lalitambika and Astha Nayar. Now the next person is Henry Kissinger. So if I talk about him guys, He has recently passed away at the age of 100. So he is a renowned political figure also, as well as he is a controversial figure also. Because he has received the Nobel Peace Prize, that is in the year 1973. But it was a very controversial award. The reason I will tell you, dekhiye, controversial isliye tha, because he, along with the Vietnamese person, that is the Lee Duc Tho. So they have won the Nobel Prize for basically USA-Vietnam War. For making a peace deal in 1973. Now, what happened after that? 2 years later, after 2 years, the war again started. And the persons who have given them the award, two members of the Nobel Committee, they have decided we should quit this thing because we have made a blunder here. This person should not get the award because peace to maintain who he nahi. That's the first thing here. Along with he has tried, he has said that I want to return my Nobel Peace Prize. But that award was not being उन्होंने accept ही नहीं किया जूरी ने कि आप अपना award वापस कर दो. So that is the controversy he has with him. Then the next controversy थोड़ा सा बता रहा हूँ, that is if a question examiner बहुत ज़्यादा फैल गया तो वो आपसे ये पूछ सकता, तो याद रखना यार भोपाल गैस tragedy. He is not a person who is involved here. The point is the firm that was involved in the भोपाल गैस tragedy. The case for that firm in America was handled by his firm. Now, the first homework question for you is, you have to tell me the main company which was involved in the Bhopal gas tragedy. Because that's something, as you can see here, examiners are now basically playing with you on these kind of things. So, that is one thing you should remember here, Bhopal gas tragedy. Bas itna yaad rakhna agar puchenge bhi. Along with that, if I talk about him, guys, so he has served as a Secretary of State for the USA under the presidentship of, that is, Mr. Richard Nixon, and her successor, that is, Gerald Ford here. So these are the points to be remembered with respect to Mr. Harry Crenser here. And next thing is, guys, the World AIDS Day recently observed yesterday, that's on 1st of December. So the points to be remembered, kab hota hai? 1st of December ko hota hai. Aur hamari theme kya hai? Theme is Let Communities Lead. That theme is important from the perspective of the examination here. So this was about your topics with respect to phase 1 and phase 2 and your phase 1 topics. Jahan pe humne do schemes padhe, PM Janam padha. We have talked about the fast track special code schemes. Then we have talked about the three prominent personalities, V.R. Lalit Ambika, Astha Sattar, and Henry Crenser. And then we are ending the session with the World AIDS Day here. Now it's time for practice hai, guys. So honestly, what do you want to do? अब यहाँ पे ये नहीं कि मैं सारे आंसर बता दूंगा तो बड़ा बड़ा आंसर नोट नहीं. यू हैव टू सी दैट हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू आर गॉटिंग द मार्क्स हियर एंड टेल मी अबाउट योर मार्क्स आल्सो. दैट इज फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स आर करेक्ट विद रिगार्ड्स टू पीएम जन्म स्कीम हियर. इट इज द प्रोविजन ऑफ प्रोवाइडिंग पक्का हाउस इज बिल्कुल सही है जी. इट इज द प्रोविजन ऑफ प्रोवाइडिंग 0.3 किलोवाट सोलर ऑफ ग्रिड सिस्टम टू 10,000 नहीं 1 लाख हाउस होल्ड्स है. इट्स अ सेंट्रल स्पॉन्सर्ड स्कीम. एब्सोल्युटली राइट गाइस. सो आंसर विल बी ऑप्शन नंबर सी. 1 एंड 3 विल बी द आंसर हियर. Moving towards the next question, ISRO scientist V.R. Lalit Ambika ji, she has been conferred with the legendary honor. The question is, the award was awarded in which of the following year? So we know it was awarded by Napoleon Bonaparte in 1802. So answer will be option number C here. Next question. Recently, Arshia Sattar, she has been received the award, that is the Order of Arts and Letters by the French government. Now, she has also received the Sahitya Academy Award. हमने पढ़ा था किस epic साहा के लिए उनको मिला था. That she, the book she has written for the children, that is Mahabharata for children. So, answer again here will be option number C here, guys. So, अब लग रहा होगा सर आपने तो फटाफट में क्वेश्चन करवा दिए. जब हमने पढ़ ही लिया यार तो फटाफट में क्वेश्चन सॉल्व करना तो बहुत ही आसान आप सबके लिए. And now is the final thing, your homework question for the day. So, I'm standing here. So that you all can see the homework question here and tell me quickly in the chat box, guys, that is ke kis kis ko ye answer aata hai. And also do let me know, do question hoge ye wala ek maine pucha Bhopal gas tragedy wala, to dono question aapko mujhe batana hai, apne marks bhi bataiye kitne marks aapne score kiye hain. Now let's talk about the homework question for the day, guys, that I've discussed with you in the previous lecture. So first was that we were discussing about the Indian Film Festival of India, and my question was which of the following film has won the best film award, and the answer was option number A, Endless Border has received the best film award. Kantara ke liye maine bola tha Rishabh Shetty ji ko award mila, that's the special jury award that he has won here. Now guys, with this question, and there was a confusion here little bit in with respect to the options here, so I've written only two here, so it will not be only two. the correct answer I've got. I'm really glad to see this thing, guys, that in the comment box, all of you have given me the answer here. So answer here will be option number B, 2 and 3 are incorrect here. Because 10 nahi, 15 days ki training aur 2023-24 se 2025-26 tak di gayi hai. That's the thing to be remembered here. So that is why these two statements are wrong here. And the answer will become option number B, 2 and 3. Or it will be 2 and 3 will be the answer here. So guys, now let me show you my shining stars here. Because mujhe lagta hai ki sabse best mauka hota hai yahi pe dekhne ka. So I can again see Nilesh, Molly, Rushi, Dennis. I can say RJ video. So really thankful for that comment. Abhay is here. Karbi is here. Thikai ji. Tamiz, I am seeing you after a lot of time. So he is also a really good member. So I dekh raha hu kafi bache regular ho chuke hain. Pushottam is here. Darshika. ठीक है, सेजल इज हियर, सो रौनक श्रीवास्तव इज हियर. सो गाइस, रियली ग्लैड टू सी ऑल ऑफ यू दैट यू गाइस आर पार्टिसिपेटिंग हियर एंड आई कैन सी मेजॉरिटी ऑफ यू आर गिविंग मी द आंसर राइट हियर. सो दैट्स रियली रियली नाइस ऑफ ऑल ऑफ यू. ठीक है, एंड गाइस डू पार्टिसिपेट लाइक दिस इन द रिमेनिंग सेशन, इन द अदर सेशंस आल्सो. नाउ इफ यू हैव एनी काइंड ऑफ डाउट और द थिंग इज एनीथिंग यू वांट टू डिस्कस विद मी, फील फ्री टू डिस्कस विद मी on our email ID, that is by dropping an email at hello@arrowtab.co.in. You can also connect with me on the number that is 8146207241. And guys, if you have really enjoyed the session, to comment box mein batao ke session kaisa laga. Uske saath, you can subscribe to the YouTube channel for getting the latest notification with respect to not about this session, but also about the other things that we are bringing for you. And for the PTF, kindly subscribe to our Telegram channel, the link for which is given in the description below here. So this was all about this session, guys. So I wish you all the best for the upcoming lectures as well as for your upcoming examination also. So again, wishing you all the best. Bye-bye.